Looking at these pieces, one would imagine they're probably made of paper mache or wood, but it's actually a fusion of glass and metal. And it's an ancient form which dates back to the times of Mohenjo-daro, which has been revived by a Mumbai-based artist who's joining us today, Gunjan Kolagi, who's in fact all set to hold her first major exhibition in Mumbai. Tell us a little bit about it. What made you, bring these sort of unique forms together?
I first learnt about this from certain people who were doing it, and then I learnt the technique. And then I started developing on my own. I felt that this is a technique which people have used on very small scales. And here, I'm an artist and I paint. So I could use the paint, the way I paint, along with the same kind of media. And I introduced it into a art piece.
You talked about how it dates back to the, through ancient Mohenjo-daro times. How was it used then? What is different about the way you're doing it now?
Mohenjo-daro times, we believe that they must have used it along with heat, the way we use heat. But that must have been, using coal or something like that. But now we do it electrically. We use the heat electrically. Basically, you clean up the metal and put the glass powder on it and fire it. This is what we do. Earlier on, in earlier times, they used to put glass pieces on it and fire it with a pointed heat or something like that so that it would fuse.
And it all happens out of this little kitchen here, which also doubles up as Gunjan's studio. Gunjan, why don't you show us something?
This is a small little copper plate, which we normally fire in the skin here. You need pure copper for this form. So you have to anneal it, clean it out, and then scrub it, and then use the powder on, glass powder on it. Some pieces like these flowers, for example, they've been fired again and again. First you cut it, shape it up, and then go on layering it and firing it. In some places you will see that there are textures which are not allowed to disappear.
And they're not merging with each other.
They are not merging with each other, so I've left them like that. Here I wanted it more smoothened out.
Do you find now people are more responsive to these innovative and more unique kinds of art forms?
People who are looking for special art going for this kind of a thing. People are looking for something new, completely new. So this is a totally different style, and this is the first time we are launching it in a big way into Indian art scene as well as Bombay art scene.
What has been the response so far whenever you've exhibited?
So far they were amazed and they couldn't understand how they must be fired really, because any time I had these kind of things, they would touch it and say, how did you paint it? Mm-hmm. So they couldn't understand that they were fired in the kiln. So basically this work can only be done by firing in the kiln. You can't just paint it and keep it.
So what do you plan to do with this piece once it dries? Would you be?
I would be firing it now, and now you'll see a little bit of golden, little bit of blue.
Tell me about some of the pieces you're going to be displaying at the exhibition.
Okay, the fish will of course be displayed. I also want to display the log, and some of them I want to put them in like small pieces. I want to put them together so that it will make into one big piece or a wall hanging or something like that.
NDTV's cricket app. Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.